Turning now to the historic visit of Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky to the Philippines. Manila expressing support for an upcoming global peace summit in Switzerland, focusing on Russia's war in Ukraine. Pia Gutierrez reports.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky hold a landmark meeting in Malacañang. The Ukrainian leader made a surprise visit to Manila to meet with Marcos Jr. Monday morning as he continues to drum up Asian support for an upcoming global peace summit later this month. During the short meeting, Zelensky thanked Marcos for the Philippine support for Ukraine.
We are very thankful to be in your country and which supports Ukraine, our territorial integrity and sovereignty. Thank you so much for your big word and clear position about us, about this Russian occupation of our territories. I'm happy to hear today from you that you participate our peace steps to the peace. That's real thing. What really want our people, just to bring peace to our homes. Thank you for participation of peace summit. That's very strong signal.
Marcos Jr. meanwhile assured his Ukrainian counterpart that the Philippines will continue to help Ukraine promote peace and bring an end to the fighting. The Philippine leader also welcomed news of Kyiv's plans to establish an embassy in Manila later this year.
I know that the crisis in your country has occupied all of your attention and all of your time, and it is a great pleasure to meet with you to discuss some of the issues that are common to our two countries, and hopefully find ways forward for both of us together. We will continue to do all that we can to promote peace and to bring an end to the fighting.
Both leaders were not able to meet each other in Singapore when they attended the Shangri-La dialogue. In an interview, Zelensky said Marcos himself confirmed that he will attend the Global Peace Summit, which will be held in Switzerland.
Yes, he said that Philippines will support the summit. I said for us it's very important him to come. He said he will come and he will participate in the summit. This great strong signal.
Zelensky highlighted the need to rally international support towards lasting peace in Ukraine, as he noted the importance of diplomacy and unity in ending the war.
Any possibility to win in this unprovoked war, and that will be the signal. If Ukraine will stay strong with the unity, with the diplomacy, with the unity in diplomacy of different countries in different regions, if we will stay strong, it means that it will give very important signal to other countries not to try even to think how to occupy it, other independent countries.
According to Zelensky, some 100 countries have already confirmed their attendance to the summit, which aims to inspire a future peace process by providing a platform for dialogue on ways towards peace in Ukraine based on international law. While Malacañang has confirmed the Philippines' participation in the summit, they have yet to confirm whether President Marcos himself will travel to Switzerland to attend the event.
China railing against President Marcos following his pointed remarks at Asia's top defense summit in Singapore. During his keynote message, Marcos condemned what he calls illegal, aggressive, and deceptive actions that continue to violate Manila's sovereign rights and jurisdiction. But in a statement released by the Chinese embassy, Beijing's foreign ministry slams Marcos's speech, calling it a disregard of history and facts. It reiterates China's claims are based on historical and legal grounds, and Manila's arbitral victory is illegal, null and void. It also blames the Philippines yet again for the recent escalation of tensions in the West Philippine Sea. China asserts it will continue to defend its territory, but it is not closing the doors for possible negotiations with Manila to settle their maritime row. Controversial Bamban Cardoc Mayor Alice Go slapped with a six-month suspension by the Office of the Ombudsman. In a statement, Go said she accepts the ombudsman order as she maintained her innocence. She added she is ready to cooperate with authorities to ensure the truth and justice will be achieved. Go and two other Bamban officials were suspended following a complaint filed by the Interior and Local Government Department. The DILG earlier filed charges of grave misconduct, serious dishonesty, and gross neglect of duty against Go in connection to a raid at a Pogo compound in Bamban last March. Aside from the ombudsman, the Office of the Solicitor General is conducting a probe on Go's background.
We're looking at a different angle other than the administrative or criminal complaint that might have been filed against Mayor Guo before the ombudsman. So walang effect, except probably mawawalan si Mayor Guo ng control over the evidence that may be available in her office because she'll be suspended preventively.
Senators, meanwhile, welcome Go's suspension. For Senator Risa Ontiveros, the order is justified. Senator Sherwin Gatchalian, meanwhile, said Go's suspension is a step in the right direction. The Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission also preparing a tax evasion case against Bamban Mayor Alice Go. The agency says the case will cover years when Go was still a private citizen. Aside from her alleged links to Pogos, Go's lavish lifestyle also came under scrutiny as the Senate investigates her background.
I could not quantify, pero malaki ho. Kita mo naman ang lifestyle ni Mayora. Yung anti-graft, kung hindi ako nagkakamali, na nasampahan na po siya. So hindi na po namin siya sasampahan noon. Maaring sampahan din po namin siya ng mga violation ng security regulation code. Maging yung iba pa pong mga opisyales nung Hong Sheng at saka nung Sun Yuan at Bao Po.
The agency is also considering another case against Go in relation to violations of the Securities and Regulations Code. Evacuations underway in Negros Island as Mount Canlaon rumbles. Monday's eruption lasted for 6 minutes, producing a 5,000-meter plume. State volcanologists also raised alert level 2 amid the possibility of further eruptions. Based on the island's latest figures, nearly 200 residents have already evacuated. The Social Welfare Department also sent food packs, hygiene kits, and face masks to affected communities. The eruption comes nearly 5 years since Mount Canlaon's last volcanic activity.
As of the monitoring the whole evening, wala kaming reported na volcanic eruption. Yung mga affected individuals nasa ano po sila mga evacuation center such as sa mga municipal evacuation center, sa mga central school, sa mga gym. We are coordinating with the LGUs to assess kung ano pa yung mga needs nila, and the PDRRMC of Negros Occidental is closely coordinating as well to prepare for the possible deployments po ng ating mga relief pack as sa mga affected na mga LGUs.
Let's now get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Veronica Torres. Good morning, Veronica.
Good morning to you and to all of our audience in ENC. Currently, the frontal system is still affecting extreme northern Luzon, so we're expecting cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over Batanes, Cagayan, Isabela, Apayao, and Ilocos Norte. For Metro Manila and the rest of the country, we're expecting partly cloudy to cloudy skies with chances of localized thunderstorms. We're not monitoring any low-pressure area or tropical cyclone near or inside the Philippine area of responsibility, and we don't have any gale warning raised over any parts of the country. And that's the latest from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. Veronica C. Torres reporting.
Thank you very much for that update, Veronica. 4 more Israeli hostages abducted by Hamas have died in captivity. That's according to the Israeli military, which says new intelligence led to the confirmation of their deaths. Hamas said one of the hostages died from injuries sustained in Israeli airstrikes. All 4 were filmed alive in videos posted by the militant group. Israelis protesting near the U.S. Embassy in Tel Aviv expressed their disappointment at the news.
I feel terrible. I feel like they are part of my family that died today, and I feel that from week to week we hear about more and more hostages that are dying, and now we are in a critical moment, and if we're not gonna negotiate and we'll make a hostage deal, there's no hope for this country, to Israel.
We just got a terrible news. It's a crazy situation that we're counting each days and each day, another day and another day. And then the number of the hostages is just going down, and not because of their coming back to Israel.
Of the more than 250 people abducted on October 7, about 120 remain in Gaza based on Israeli tallies. Israeli officials have said many are presumed dead. South Korea planning to convene a UN Security Council meeting on human rights abuses in North Korea this month. The move is likely to anger Pyongyang and face opposition from Russia and China. South Korea's UN ambassador says he hopes there would be significant support among council members. The 15-member council last met on the issue in August 2023. China opposed it then, but did not try to block the meeting due to lack of support.
Advancement of the DPRK's WMD program is closely intertwined with the dire human rights and humanitarian situation in the country, like two sides of the same coin. In this regard, we firmly believe that the Security Council should not neglect the latent risks that systematic human rights violations in DPRK pose to international peace and security. Human rights and peace and security issues should be approached in a holistic manner, especially in the case of the DPRK.
North Korea has repeatedly rejected accusations of abuses and blamed sanctions for a dire humanitarian situation in the reclusive state. Mexico's President Andrés Manuel López Obrador laying the groundwork for the country's change in leadership. Obrador says his finance minister will remain in his post for some time to help facilitate the transition. Claudia Sheinbaum from Obrador's Morena party will become Mexico's first female president after a landslide election victory. Sheinbaum promises to continue the work of her mentor Obrador, whose help for the poor made him highly popular. She is expected to take office on October 1st. A jury has been selected in the first trial of the child of a sitting U.S. president. Hunter Biden is facing three felony charges in Washington, D.C., stemming from his purchase and possession of a revolver in 2018. He has pleaded not guilty. This is one of the two criminal cases he faces, with federal tax charges brought separately in California. The historic prosecution could further influence the 2024 presidential election, coming 4 days after Donald Trump became the first former U.S. president to be convicted. Opening arguments are expected Tuesday. Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our Bureau Chief, DJ Manotok.
Good morning to our friends at The Rundown. We begin with stories from the political front as strategists from the Democratic and Republican parties weighing in on the future of Donald Trump after he became the first former U.S. president convicted of crimes.
Trump to jail! Philan Republican political consultant Jeff Coleman thinks Donald Trump should be pardoned.
I think it's time to get the Trump kind of bedroom salacious details off the front pages and allow these candidates, because he will be the Republican nominee, to debate the issues.
Trump was convicted last week by a Manhattan jury on all 34 counts of falsifying business records to influence the 2016 presidential election.
If enough Republicans say, we are going to lose this, we're going to lose Senate seats, we're going to lose congressional seats, they may turn the tide and decide to vote for someone else to run for the president of the United States. And that could be Nikki Haley. It could be Ron DeSantis.
Legal experts say the appeal process that usually takes several months is unlikely to be resolved before the November presidential election. Democrat political strategist Cheryl Quinio-Blojet thinks it would be an uphill battle for Trump's defense team.
Judge Marchand was very clear with some of the direction and even some of the pushback of certain witnesses, even for the prosecution.
Coleman believes Trump will not go to prison. Falsifying business records in New York comes with a maximum prison sentence of 4 years.
Most observers, I think, realize the complexity, especially with the Secret Service charged with guarding a former president, of having an inmate of that profile and that stature in a prison with additional or separate security and all the accommodations that have to be made for that.
In sports, Philippine-American hockey star Jason Robertson's NHL season has come to an end.
The NHL season is over for Jason Robertson after the Edmonton Oilers eliminated the Dallas Stars on Sunday night in Edmonton, Canada. The Oilers took Game 6 in the best-of-seven Western Conference Finals with a 2-1 win. The Phil-Am hockey star, who pulled off a hat-trick in Game 4, took a team-high 9 shots on goal in Game 6 but could not score. Robertson ends the 2023-2024 regular season with 29 goals and 51 assists, for a total of 80 points. While his individual stats were down compared to last year, he continued to be a factor in the Stars' deep playoff run. The NHL Stanley Cup Finals are now set for this week, with the Oilers taking on the Florida Panthers.
And ending this news break on a high note, Filipina-Japanese golfer Yuka Saso has won her second U.S. Women's Open Championship in the last 4 years.
The 22-year-old Filipina-Japanese golfer came from 3 strokes behind to claim victory in the U.S. Women's Open. Saso finished the final day with a score of 2 under par 68 and a 4-day total of 4 under par 276. Saso began the day with a birdie on the second hole.
Oh, man.
But faced a setback with a double bogey in the sixth. But she showed her grit on the back nine, carding birdies on the 12th, 13th, and 16th holes.
Calls it right in and
then, despite a nervous 3-putt on the 17th, she finished strong with a clutch chip on the 18th to save par. At the trophy presentation, an emotional Saso thanked her family.
My caddy as well, thank you so much. Appreciate all the patience and everything. And my family. I wouldn't be here without their support. So thank you so much if you guys are watching.
And those are the top stories making the headlines in the North American region. You can catch more of our TFC News on our website, news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News, and head on over to the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel. I'm TJ Monotok. Back to our friends at The Rundown.